Is screen visible, Harsh? So let us study today the next polar next coding scheme. Yesterday we have studied the Manchester differential, Manchester return to zero, and what were the drawbacks with the NRZL and NRZI. In drawbacks, that the two schemes does not meet the criteria for a good coding scheme. They were missing with the synchronization, and also their bandwidth were high. DC components were present, so the NRZL, NRZI could not be considered as a good coding scheme, and they are obsolete nowadays. After this, we studied the return to zero coding scheme, which also face problem. The problems are the DC components are present, bandwidth greater is required, large bandwidth is required for return to zero coding scheme. So this coding scheme is also not used nowadays. Next, we studied the a mixture of return to zero plus non-return to zero level and inverted coding scheme, which is Manchester when we include return to zero plus non-return to zero level scheme, differential Manchester, which is a combination of return to zero and non-return to zero inversion coding scheme. And we know that the differential Manchester or Manchester, the inversion one will include the change in the level of voltage will represent a bit, and inversion case, that is differential Manchester, the inversion or lack of inversion will decide the bit. If in next bit is zero, there will be inversion. If next bit is one, then there will be no inversion. So in Manchester and differential Manchester, the levels of the voltages and the lack or inversion capability will decide the bit. Now next we have the bipolar coding schemes. These coding schemes are also called as the multi-level binary coding schemes. These schemes are called as multi-level binary coding schemes. Why? Because they utilize the three voltage levels, positive, negative and zero. And three voltage levels are used for one data element. And these data elements are nothing but the stream of bits of zeros or ones. We can have two types of coding schemes, that is AMI coding scheme or a pseudo ternary coding scheme. In AMI coding scheme, we have alternate mark inversion coding scheme, the full form of AMI. AMI means alternate one inversion. A neutral zero voltage represents a binary zero. Let us see how it is doing. In case of AMI, that is full form alternate mark inversion, here a bit zero is equivalent to a voltage zero, but a bit one is equal to a positive voltage or a negative voltage alternately. What it means, if we have a sequence of zeros and ones, all zeros in AMI will be represented by a zero voltage level, and all ones in AMI will be represented by voltage level plus V or minus V. Why plus V and minus V? Because if first one in the sequence is represented by a plus V voltage, the next one in the bit stream will be represented by a negative voltage, and next one positive, next negative voltage. That's why alternate positive negative voltages represents a bit. If you see the figure, the zero is represented by a zero voltage level. One is represented by a plus V, positive voltage. Then continuous two zeros are represented by zero voltage. Then one is represented by a negative voltage, plus V and minus V. Can you see the cursor on the screen? What I am writing? Okay, thank you. Next coding scheme is the pseudo ternary scheme. In pseudo ternary scheme, we represent, it is reverse of AMI. Here we represent a zero by plus or minus voltage alternately. One is represented by a zero volt. So here, this is one which is represented by a zero volt. This is one which is represented by a zero volt. And a bit zero is represented by alternate plus V and minus V voltages. You can clearly see here, plus V for zero volt, then we have a one. So it is represented by zero voltage. Then we have a zero represented by negative voltage. Then we again have zero. So alternate, it should have a positive voltage. Then we have one. It is represented by a zero voltage. Then again we have one, which is represented by a negative voltage. Its bandwidth graph is shown in the slide. It has a small contribution at lower frequencies, but major contribution is at higher frequencies. So due to this small contribution, there is disadvantage in this series that the near zero frequency, the energy is concentrated, and this result into some DC component is present in this coding scheme. So this coding scheme cannot be used for long distance communication because of the lower energy concentration at lower frequencies and presence of the some DC components, not major DC component, but some DC components are present. Now, how to avoid this DC component and how to use the this AMI and pseudo ternary scheme to send the data to the long distances? So the idea is the scrambling. So what actually is scrambling? These are of two type coding schemes, B8ZS and HDB3. So these coding schemes are used when AMI and pseudo ternary have long sequence of zeros and ones and have energy concentrated near the lower frequencies to avoid the DC components and to send the information to longer distances. We have to use a new technique called as scrambling. Also, the wide bandwidth requirement of AMI and pseudo ternary is also reduced by this process of scrambling. Now, what this process of scrambling is, it utilizes two coding schemes, B8ZS and HDB3. Scrambling is done parallelly with the coding. We have a sender. Sender sends some information in AMI code. With AMI, a scrambling is also done, which is observed in the signal as violated digital signal, and then it is received at the receiving end, and receiver will separate the scrambling part and the original message. Now let us understand what is this scrambling. B8ZS means bipolar with 8-0 substitution. Suppose in the data we have very very large sequence of zeros and ones, and we know we have to have avoid a long sequence of zeros and ones for AMI and pseudo ternary scheme to send at larger distances. So see, this is a sequence of continuous 8 zeros. This is also a continuous sequence of 8 zeros. So there are two possible ways to do the coding. Here we will replace these 8 zeros with a code called as violation, V for violation, B for bipolar. So eight consecutive zeros will be replaced by a sequence of bit that is 000, V a violation, B a bipolar, again 0, V for violation, B for bipolar. So eight zeros are represented by this. So if one is represented by a positive voltage, then we have a eight consecutive zeros. So these eight consecutive zeros are now replaced with 30 followed by a violation. Then we have a bipolar, then again a zero, then again a violation and a bipolar. So what this violation actually is? Violation is actually is the hello. कोई बोलना चाह रहा है? Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So violation means the rules of AMI and pseudo ternary. If they are violated, then we say a violation. And we have recently studied in case of AMI and pseudo ternary that a zero bit is represented by 0 volt, a plus one is represented by one bit is represented by a positive voltage or the negative voltage. So reverse is in case of pseudo ternary. If those rules are violated in the sequence, then sequence means the representation of the bit by voltage level. So I have circulated these three voltage levels in both the graphs. So both the graphs represent a bit. One represented by positive, V here represents a violation because fourth bit is not a zero here to avoid that. Bipolar, zero is represented by negative voltage, so that is pseudo ternary. So this B8ZS is a coding scheme which is encoded with the AMI and pseudo ternary. So when we are talking about B8ZS, then we are talking about simultaneously AMI pseudo ternary as well. Here we can note that the scrambling in this case does not change the bit rate. Also, this technique balances the positive and negative voltage levels. Why it balances? Because if you see, two are the bipolar and two are the violations, so these balance the voltage levels. Else if we have taken 8 bits continuously, then we had a 0 volt for 8 continuous bits, but now 2 bits represents violations, 2 bit represents bipolar, so the voltage level is also balanced and this continuity of stream of continuous zeros or ones is also violated. V means same polarity as the polarity of the previous non-zero pulse. B means polarity is opposite to the polarity of the previous non-zero pulse. You can see here, B is represented as a negative pulse here, first B, second B is opposite. The second coding scheme is the high density bipolar 30. So in this coding scheme, the continuous stream of 4 continuous zeros is replaced with 00V or a B00V. This coding scheme is represented by this diagram. Here you can see 4 continuous zeros are there. The second substitution also have 4 consecutive zero. So the substitution are 2. Either we can substitute them with 000V or B00V. Here V is violation, B is bipolar. So first substitution we have done is B00V. Second substitution is 000V. Third substitution for 4 consecutive zeros is B00V. So these are the techniques which we are talking of are because we have to send data for the long distance communication. We may face the problem that data may have consecutive zeros. So to avoid that, AMI and pseudo ternary are used for avoiding the 8 8 bit streams consecutively 0, that is B8ZS with AMI or pseudo ternary avoids long sequence of continuous zeros, and HDB3 avoids long continuous sequence of 0 by substituting 4 zeros with B00B.